What's up, internet? Bibili ka ng RGB para sa computer mo, parang ganito. And gusto mo malaman, gusto mo siguraduhin na compatible yung RGB na yon dun sa system mo. Usually sa series na to, kinukuha natin step by step lahat ng mga basic parts ng computer and then minamatch natin yon. So kung bibili ka ng X, kailangan mo tutukan yung motherboard, yung casing, yung PSU, yung iba hindi, parang ganon. Yan yung usual setup ng series na to, pero to be honest, nakakalito yung RGB. Parang hindi makatulong kung dumaan tayo dun sa usual list natin.
Ang video na to ay handog ni cdkoffers.com. Marami kang mahahanap na iba't ibang uri ng software dito. May games, apps, activation codes for Windows 10. Check out our video on CDK Offers in the video description. Mabilis, mura, and syempre legit dito. Madali lang mag-order, search for the software you need, add to cart, check out, daan ka sa payment options nila, wala pa isang minuto, finished. May legit working CDK ka na sa software na pinili mo. Gamitin ang aming promo code para makakuha pa ng extra 20% discount sa purchase mo. Kung naghahanap ka ng mura, legit, and original software, check out cdkoffers.com.
So, para mas malinaw, dadaan lang muna tayo kung ano yung RGB and ano yung different kinds of RGB. Kasi sa totoo lang, sobrang nakakalito tong RGB na to. We build a lot of rigs here at Hardware Sugar and we're always very careful dun sa RGB. Kasi kung magkamali ka, either hindi mo magamit lahat ng functions ng RGB or kulang yung hardware mo para mapatakbo lahat ng RGB na binili ni customer or yung software na ginagamit ng customer para ma-customize yung RGB hindi tugma or hindi compatible dun sa iba pang mga components na RGB rin. So it's really very confusing, to be honest, kasi iba-ibang manufacturers, iba-ibang standards. Just to boil it down to its very basics, number one, ano ba tong RGB na to? RGB means red, green, and blue. Kung sinama mo yung tatlong colors na yan, the different variations of red, green, and blue, you can form any color. So yun yung ibig sabihin ng RGB, na it doesn't mean kung RGB, red, green, or blue lang yung ma-display ng component na yun. It can really display any color. Yan yung kagandahan ni RGB. And I had a customer before who asked me, ano bang mga kulay niyan? So sabi ko, RGB. Tapos sabi niya, ilang kulay madi-display niyan? And so napa-research pa ako, you know, it's something like in the hundreds or I forget, millions or something. Pero there are so many variations na magawa mo. Basically, it's any color. Yun na lang yun. RGB means any color, to be, you know, very blunt about it. You can customize it, you can set it to different colors, to different settings. So yun yung RGB. Pero may iba't ibang uri ng RGB. Number one is the older form of RGB na tawag lang sa kanya RGB. Tapos may mas bagong version of RGB, tawag sa kanya ARGB or addressable RGB or digital RGB. So pareho lang yun lahat. Addressable RGB, ARGB, digital RGB, pareho lang yan. Then dun sa older version, RGB or non-digital RGB, pareho lang yan. What's the difference? Yung RGB, gumagamit siya ng 12-volt and 4-pin RGB header. We'll talk about why that's important in a bit. Yung ARGB, gumagamit siya ng 5-volt or 3-pin RGB header. But for the consumer, bottom line is, mas maganda yung ARGB in terms of the color and in terms of the kinds of lighting that you can have. Mas maganda yung ARGB. Bakit? Kasi si RGB, yes, nakokontrol mo siya, pero lahat ng ilaw naka-series yon, and you can only control it per series, hindi per light. What do I mean? Let's say you have an RGB product and it has 5 LEDs. Kung RGB yon, nakokontrol mo lang lahat sila at the same time. There, you can only control it as a unit, as a series. So kung yung 5 na yun, red lang yun lahat, blue lang yun lahat, yellow lang yun lahat. Yes, you can change the colors and they can change rapidly. Let's say, pwede may flash, red, green, yellow, ma-epilepsy ka dyan, blue, orange, purple, whatever. Kailangan mo, pwede may flash yun sunod-sunod. Yung problema, hindi mo kaya na each individual LED mapalitan yung kulay at the same time. Isang kulay lang talaga yan, all at the same time. So, if it's red, it's gonna be red all the time, blue, etc. Lahat yun all at the same time. Yung maganda sa ARGB, hindi siya series. So, let's say you have the same product, 5 LEDs, pero ARGB siya. Hindi ka stuck dun na one color all at the same time. At the same time, pwede mo palitan yung lima na yon to different colors. So the first one can be red, the second one can be blue, the third can be green, the fourth can be yellow, the fifth can be violet, and then papalit-palit yan. So because you have such granular control or kasi sobrang minute nung control mo dun sa RGB product, isipin mo individual LED na ko-control mo, mas maganda talaga, mas vivid, mas dynamic yung mga lighting setups nung ARGB. So there are really some lighting effects na kaya ni ARGB na hindi kaya ni RGB. To make things more confusing, may ibang mga high-end brands like Corsair or NZXT, yung tawag lang nila sa mga RGB products sila RGB. Pero usually, ARGB yun, or meaning mas maganda yung lighting effects na kaya nila. Usually kasi yung mga yun, ginagamit nila yung 5V din sila. Kung 5V yung RGB, that is automatically ARGB. Even though it's not classified as ARGB or it's not classified as digital RGB. Okay, let's say, maganda yung RGB, sold ka na, gusto mo bumili. What do you need to know? Para ma-control mo or para ma-customize mo yung RGB lighting, like, ma-set mo to breathing, malagay mo red and then green to blue, whatever, you need to have software control. Lahat yun nakasalalay sa motherboard. Kung bibili ka ng RGB, you need to make sure na yung motherboard mo may 12V 4-pin RGB header. Kung bibili ka ng ARGB, siguraduhin mo na yung motherboard mo may 5V 3-pin ARGB header. And kung bibili ka ng mga high-end na RGB like for NZXT or Corsair, yung mga yun, they don't use the motherboard headers. They usually have their own controllers which plug into the internal USB slot of the motherboard. Sasaksak mo lahat ng mga RGB products nila dun sa controller, and then in turn, yung controller na yun, sasaksak mo dun sa internal USB slot nung motherboard mo. So depending on what kind of RGB products you're going to get, make sure you have the proper headers to control them. Madalas na mangyari na bibili si customer ng RGB kasi nawili sa mga magagandang ilaw. Pero pagbalik sa bahay, i-install niya, tapos na-realize niya, pucha, medyo complicated pala to ah. Saan ko isasaksak to? Wala pala akong RGB header sa motherboard. We did do an old video before where you can have RGB in an old system, pero medyo mahirap siyang gawin. Ngayon, yung mga bagong boards, maganda kasi they both have RGB headers and ARGB headers. Mas nagiging uso yun ngayon. I've even seen some boards like from MSI na may special Corsair header sila na para talaga dun sa mga RGB products ng Corsair. Although those are very uncommon, mahirap makahanap nun. Usually, you plug those into the controller of Corsair. But bottom line for beginners, if you want to use software control para mapalitan yung mga RGB settings mo, you need to make sure na yung motherboard mo compatible. Yun nga, kung may RGB header, kung RGB binili mo, ARGB header, if your products are ARGB, and if your items are using a controller, kung may internal USB slot ba yung motherboard. Now, I've talked about software control, and usually this is the recommended way how to control RGB kasi mas maganda talaga yung effects na makukuha mo and mas madali yung control mo kasi napapalitan mo dun sa desktop. However, there are some RGB products that come with physical controller, so usually parang paminsan may remote control, paminsan may wired control na kailangan mo pang hanapin sa loob ng case mo and then papalitan mo yung lighting. Sometimes you can thread it out, parang linalabas mo siya, pero hindi maganda tingnan yun sa setup. There are some systems that allow you to wire the RGB to the reset button of the case. Yun, magandang solution yun. There are some cases like this one, the MSI Vampiric, may RGB button talaga yung case para mapalitan mo lang yung case lighting dun sa via that button. But generally, hindi recommended yung physical controllers for RGB kasi it's not a very neat solution if it's a physical controller. And pangalawa, yun nga, mas may control ka talaga, mas gamay mo yung RGB mo kung nagagamit mo yung software control. It's an option, and if you want a physical controller, then that's your choice. Although generally, the trend now is na software control talaga para sa RGB. Sige, daan muna tayo sa listahan natin, yung usual list natin, and sabihin natin kung ano bang ma-RGB-fied or ano ba yung mga products na may RGB usually. Yung CPU, walang RGB yan. Yung CPU cooler, yes, paminsan may RGB. Yung motherboard, paminsan, yes, may RGB na rin yung motherboard. GPU, yes, paminsan meron. Case, yes, meron. Storage, paminsan yung SSDs, may nakakita na ako na may RGB. Yung RAM, yes, may RGB na rin. PSU, yes, may PSU na rin with RGB, notably from Thermaltake. And actually, I think parang yun na yung lahat ng products. Parang lahat ng posibleng mapasok mo sa case, aside from the CPU, na hindi mo naman talaga nakikita kasi natatakpan ng CPU cooler, na RGB-fy na, like may RGB version. There are even RGB cable combs, RGB underglow. So you put them at the bottom of your case to give it like that may parang lighting na spilling out from the bottom of the case. I've seen monitors with RGB. So basically anything nowadays that you can stick into your case, may RGB version. Pero yung pinaka-common na RGB is yung fans. Sometimes they come with the case fans already have RGB. More often, you buy them separately. So Corsair, NZXT, Deepcool, Idcooling. Ang dami mga brands na may mga case fans na RGB. Usually, like even for the AIOs, the all-in-one water cooling systems, paminsan yung CPU blocks, yung mukhang scuba regulator na dinidikit dun sa CPU. Depending on the AIO, kahit yung CPU block walang RGB. Pero yung nagbibigay ng RGB, yung fans na nakalagay dun sa radiator. So, the most common item that has RGB are case fans. Kung bibili ka ng RGB or gusto mo na may RGB yung setup mo, check mo lang yung case mo how many extra fans it can take. Because that controls how many RGB fans you can have in your case. And to be honest, sobrang basic pa lang yung napag-usapan natin on how to control RGB. Sobrang nakakalito siya, and you really need to do your own research or go to your trusted shop like Hardware Sugar na, oy, gusto ko ng RGB. Kasi yung tricky dun sa RGB, you need to know if you have enough headers to control it, and you also need to know if you have enough power. Like, you want 7 fans. Masisiksik ba lahat ng 7 fans na yun dun sa isang RGB header? Usually, naka-daisy chain, so you don't need to do that. They do run out of power. Yung maganda sa RGB kumpara sa ARGB, since 12 volts siya, you can have more RGB products daisy chain together, tas nakadikit lang dun sa, nakasaksak lang dun sa isang RGB header. You do run out of power more often with a 5 volt ARGB setup. And then, so you need to figure out now where you're going to get the extra power for the rest of your RGB na hindi umiilaw. So, medyo complicated talaga siya. Pero yung pinaka-basic, yun nga yung headers mo. RGB is 12 volt 4-pin. Make sure your motherboard has that if that's what you're buying. ARGB is 5 volt 3-pin. Make sure your motherboard has that if you're buying. And if you're buying medyo high-end like Corsair, NZXT, make sure your motherboard has an internal USB slot to accommodate those. Actually, just to illustrate how complicated it gets, bibili ka lang ng all NZXT setup, H510 Elite, na may kasama ng Smart Device V2. Yung H510 Elite, may kasama ng dalawang RGB fans dun sa harap. Tapos, bibili ka pa nung AIO cooler na NZXT. Isipin mo, okay na yun kasi may Smart Device naman. Nakasama na dun sa case, NZXT naman lahat. Pero, yung Smart Device na yun, sakto lang siya dun sa mga kasama na fans. Tapos, yung NZXT, kailangan pa niya nung internal USB header. So, the Smart Device eats up one header, and then the NZXT AIO eats up another header, and then depende sa motherboard mo, usually isa lang yung available na internal USB header. Medyo nakakapanik sa gitna nung build na, pucha, akala ko tama na to, NZXT naman lahat. Tapos pala, kulang pa nung header. What we usually do is, you can actually buy an NZXT internal USB header. Yun, sobrang useful nun. Even for products that aren't from NZXT, compatible naman siya. So we've used those for the Corsair builds and other builds like that. You think na RGB lang siya, madali lang siya, pero actually, yun talaga yung pampasakit sa ulo sa mga builds. And you end up putting a lot of stuff in just to support the RGB. Yun nga, yung additional internal USB headers, fan hubs to power the fans, and other things like that. So, be sure to plan your build properly kung papasok ka ng RGB. Last na lang, siguro more knowledge, parang trivia lang. Kung napansin mo online, maraming nagsasabi na ayaw nila sa RGB. Why do people hate RGB so much? Eh, ang ganda naman tingnan, di ba? Parang maganda tingnan, pwede may control. A lot of people, at least online, do say that they don't like RGB. RGB puke yung tawag. Naghahanap sila ng mga stealth builds. Yung stealth builds, basically all black or something, anti-RGB builds. For me personally, di naman ako galit sa RGB. I think it looks pretty. Yung iba, ayaw lang sumali sa uso kasi uso-uso yung RGB ngayon. And yung iba naman, nagalit sa RGB, which I think is a position that makes more sense, is na ang dami-dami mong ginagasto sa RGB, pero hindi naman yung nagdadagdag sa performance. All of that money, and you can spend a lot on RGB, all of that money does not add 1 megahertz, does not decrease 1 second less of your waiting time sa mga loading times. Everything you spend on RGB is just money down the drain kung performance yung tinitingnan mo. So yes, magandang RGB, mag-arbo tingnan. Baka kaya galit yung ibang tao sa RGB kasi yung the purists, you know, the yung talagang bang for your buck performance-wise, wala talagang nadadagdag yung RGB sa performance. And perhaps that's why some people online are very quick to comment na, oh, RGB puke, and tinaman na itong RGB na to, parang ganyan, etc. Although there are some very tasteful builds na naka-RGB, or I've even seen them na nakalagay lang to all white or white and blue, nag-alternate sila. So, hindi naman ibig sabihin na RGB pangit kaagad. And of course, depende yun sa user, di ba? That's your computer. That's your personal computer. So, ikaw na bahala kung ano gusto mo. Kung gusto mo parang disco yung computer mo, eh, sino ba magsasabi sa'yo na mali yun, di ba? Computer mo yun eh. Pero yung nainis talaga ako, and maraming nagka-comment nito actually sa YouTube videos, does RGB add heat? Yes, it does. Pero sobrang konting-konti lang that you shouldn't even worry about it. It's such a minuscule amount. Sobrang liit lang nun yung linalagay nung, yung nadadagdag na init sa ng RGB, na you shouldn't even really worry about it. Anything that generates light also produces heat. Paminsan di mo maramdaman, hawakan mo para malamig naman, but there is some minuscule heat generation there. And ganun sa mga LEDs ng RGB. Yes, it produces light, and so therefore it produces heat. Pero yung sobrang konti lang nung heat na yon, isipin mo, kumuha ka ng baso ng tubig, tinapon mo sa dagat. Nagdagdagan ba yung tubig sa dagat? Yes. May pake ba yung mga isda sa dagat? Naapekto ba yung dagat? Tumaas ba yung water levels ng dagat? Yes to all of those things, but it doesn't matter. The fish will continue to swim. The sea water level rose incrementally. Sobrang liit lang. That it doesn't matter to the entire ecosystem. Ganon yung heat dun sa RGB. Yes, yung RGB nagproproduce siya ng heat. Pero in the greater scheme of things, sobrang liit lang nun that it doesn't matter to your case temperatures. Again, yun nga, yung analogy ko, kumuha ka ng baso ng tubig, tinapon mo sa dagat, yes, nadagdagan yung tubig sa dagat, but does that affect the sea in any perceptible, measurable, qualitative way? It does not. So kahit naka-red yung RGB mo, for all intents and purposes, hindi umiinit yung system mo. Kahit naka-10 case fans ka, lahat RGB, RGB lahat. Yes, on a very scientific, objective level, temperatures do go up. But for performance-wise, trying to, you know, you're trying to keep your system as cool as possible, walang effect yung RGB dun sa system temperatures mo. So I don't actually get the whole bandwagon. Maraming galit sa RGB, marami naman may gusto sa RGB. Here at Hardware Sugar, we really don't care what your position is. Yung position namin, computer mo yon, design mo however you want. Dream computer mo, rig mo yan, gagamitin mo yan 5-6 years, tell us what you want and we'll do it. Kung stealth build gusto mo, stealth build tayo. Kung gusto mo RGB to the wall, RGB to the limit, mag-RGB tayo na kailangan mo naka-shades para matingnan mo yung computer mo sa silaw ng RGB na lumalabas dun sa case mo. It's really up to you, and that's really what we try to push here at Hardware Sugar. Whatever the customer wants, whatever he wants for his personal computer, that's what we'll try to do. Thanks for watching.
So I hope that these basic tips helped you. If you found this video helpful, please drop a like and hit the subscribe button. For your PC needs, consider buying from us, Hardware Sugar, at Lazada, or on our website. You can find links in the description below. And thank you for watching. See you next video.